Okay, so I waited a while to do this. I don't even know if I'm gonna get them all done tonight. I'm gonna take them down. I washed it yesterday, the whole thing with the braids in it. I'm just gonna take each one down and redo it with the extension. And the bead, I'm gonna put beads back on it. I told y'all I was gonna show y'all how I extend it. In the back on the bottom row, I have 4 individual plaits to make it more full and to make it look longer. So, taking the, this is the one of the individuals. This isn't the cornrow. I'm taking it down. I've been looking for this everywhere. I found it nearby me. I found it at the beauty supply. It's called Edge Fixer. I know that Sweetie's using it, so I want to try it out. So I finally had a few dollars. I could try it out. It comes sealed. I got the watermelon. Oh, it smells just like watermelon. It smells beautiful. And it looks like it's blue, but I'm going to take a little bit out so I can see. Oh, it's clear, but it just has, it's just in a blue container. Hold on 1 minute. Okay. So I had to check on a baby. Give him a bottle. Took that braid down. I just got this edge control. I recommend it by Sweetie. It comes like this with her little thing on there. Then it's called Kiss Colors Care Edge Fixer Glued Max Hold Watermelon. So I just put a little bit on there so far. It smells absolutely great. I still have my beads, my annual revenge, and my beater. I pre-beaded a beater. I like annual revenge. They don't pop as easily. This comes with 3 bundles of braiding hair. This is Expressions hair. This is what I see most people are using. It's pre-stretched, pre-layered, pre-feathered, everything. So it should only take 1 bundle out of 3 to do my whole head, because like I said, I'm just trying to make the braids look like they're my hair, but I want to make it just a little longer. So I'm just going to take 1 bundle. That's all it should take, and it really shouldn't even take the whole bundle. So all of this can be used for something else. I'm pretty sure I probably won't even go into this at all. I also got some other stuff in here, but that's not for this. It's not a big deal. You may need some scissors. I mean, like I said, I'm just trying to make it look like a natural long. I mean, you can make it as long as you want it. But I want it to look like a long, but a natural long. My hair already is decent length. It's like to my shoulders. I just want it like to look maybe like right here. So I'm not going to, if I start putting the hair in, it's going to be a little too long. So you can cut the hair in half. And if you cut the hair in half and fold it, then it's going to be just right. Or if you want, you can just braid it like, braid with the hair like that and just cut the end off. But if you want to stretch the hair and get the most out of what you got, you can just cut half of the hair off, because I don't think I'm going to make it. I don't know. I don't think I want it that long. What do y'all think? It would be cute, but Yeah, I think that's doing the most. Really, you can cut it right where that rubber band is at. You don't have to take that off. Like I did, like an idiot. I'm just gonna put it back on. Just put the loop back through and pull it. That's how you put it back on. Yeah, I think I'm gonna cut it because I'm like debating. I know, like y'all, like you're supposed to know what you're gonna do. You're already on here, but you don't even need. So, yeah, I don't know what I wanna do. And if I don't cut it, I have the option to choose how long I want it. That's the good thing about it, if I don't cut it. So if I don't cut it, I have the option to choose if I wanna make it this long. I don't have to, so I'm not gonna cut it then. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do, I don't need the scissors. I'm just gonna, I have to close it back up because I don't have the baby to kick it over or anything while I was feeding him. So you don't need a lot of this at first. You're just gonna take a little and put it on your hair, on the root and stuff. Oh yeah, it also has, I read on the package, it has B vitamins in it, which, B7, so which is good for the hair. So put a little bit on there. Take your little rubber band off. You can help put that to the side so you can put it back on each time you pull a little hair out. Before you get started, you might want to take some hair out. That's enough for each braid probably. Because like I said, you just want it to look like your real hair. You're not really trying to like, make it look weavy. You want it to pass for your hair. So you're just going to start braiding your own hair. But you want to pull it tight though. So braid it down till you start to feel your hair start to get thin. So like braid it halfway down, and then you can put this under the hair and add it in. Once you have wefted it in 3 times like that, then you want to take. A little piece from the other weave. A little bitty piece from the other braid of the weave. And you're going to keep braiding a little like down. 1, 2, 3. Then find the smallest one that you took hair to add to that one. And you're going to take the biggest one. The other one you didn't take hair from. You're going to take a little bit of weave from that one to add to that one. So what you're trying to do is just make them 3 even little pieces. As you know, even as you can. No, it's not almost perfect, so. And you want the beads to be able to still go on, so that's why you're not putting a big thick piece of hair. You're gonna put a real small piece of hair. You're not gonna put a lot of hair. So look. It looks pretty real. You can't really see where it's added in at. And also, you can always put beads. If it shows a little bit where it's added at, you're going to have on beads. I mean, the beads will cover that up anyway. If you put the beads up high enough. So, if you do it the way I'm going to do it, put a lot of beads. Since I got so many beads, I said I'm going to just put a lot. I'm going to try something different. So, this is a different way of doing it. I know a lot of people are doing the 8-strand method and all that. This is just trying to make it look natural as possible. And the reason you put the rubber band on this weave, which is what I did, I don't know how it came on loose. Normally it doesn't come on loose. You put the rubber band on the weave to stop it from tangling up. And you know, especially when you have kids around like I do, you don't want them to go by and mess it up, brush it. Oh yeah, this is the rubber band, it ain't me. You can knot it too as well. You can just knot the hair if that's not working, like it's not working for me. Just tape is what I normally do. I normally don't even use the rubber band. I just pull the hair through and just make one knot. It's not going to knock the hair up. It's just going to stop it from being all over the place. If a kid knocks it down or somebody knocks it down, it's not going to go nowhere. So just, okay. See, I'm just pretending like a kid knocked it down or something. See, now it's still together. That's all. That's why I do that. So you can knot it in between. You don't have to. I mean, that's if you got people around you think might knock it down or something. And that helps it from getting tangled as well. So now you can just choose how long you want it. I'm not going to probably do all of them tonight. I may just do the four in the back because I'm on a time limit. I just do them as I go on. And the more beads you put on the end, the more longer you can keep it in. So, I mean, the more like you can't see where you add it in your hair. But if you do, like I've been doing this a long time, so that's why you probably can't see where I add it in. But for people that haven't been doing it a while, it won't even show if you do that. Like once I put the beads, you're not gonna be able to see anything. And because there are beads already on it, which I'm taking off as I go, you know that your hair is already small enough to fit the bead. You just got to make sure you put a small enough piece of weave and try to braid it as neat as possible. You want it to be as neat as possible, because if you're not going to put beads on it, you want it to be neat. If you don't put beads on it, you just want to knot it at the end. Instead of rubber banding it, you're just going to knot it. Because that rubber band would look good on a small little piece of hair. It'd look alright. It'd look real. And you can put a little more weave in it. If you're not going to bead it, you can put more weave. Because now it looks kind of like thin. But that's just because I'm putting beads on it. Nobody's going to really see the hair that's inside the bead. It'll look good, you know. But if I was just gonna do this for length and I wasn't gonna put no beads, of course you put a little more hair in this. You want it to be a tad bit thicker. You might do like 2 or 3 more strands of hair that size added onto that, because you want to be, you want it to look good. You want it just as thick as this, so you want the braid. This to be, see how it's half the size? The only reason it's so small is because, like I said, I'm going to add beads to it. So maybe this is the perfect length already. I'm just going to go down to like the middle of my, I don't want it like the middle of my back, I guess, the top of my arm right here. So that's pretty long. That's a decent length. Yeah, I think that's long enough. Because the longer you braid it, the more you're gonna have to work you're gonna have to do. But you don't have to make it that long for length. I mean, I could have just made it a little longer, like right here. That looks more natural. But if you want to exaggerate and you want to be like me, you want to be a little more over the top, go on and do that. Okay, so then you just take the beater. Remember I showed you guys, and there's a hole right here. You can get these from the store for $1. I think I paid $2 for these, I'm not sure. Because it's 2 came in a pack. No more than like, they don't cost no more than $5. Depends on what store you go to, how they try to mark them up, you know. There's some beads on there already, and that like just saved my life. And to keep them on there, you just leave it like that. But I'm going to fill it up with beads. So since I have so many beads, I want to use them. I'm gonna use them. I'm gonna fill it up with beads. I think that'll be hot. I've been planning to do this, since the last video, but I was so busy taking care of my baby, and just it flooded. The stuff flooded, and we couldn't figure out where the flood was coming from. So just trying to mop and stuff, my energy level had, like, I was gonna do it yesterday, but now it's like, after I mopped up everything, I was like I went to sleep. After I fed the baby and everything and changed him, I was like, me and him both were asleep, so we were both like two babies, so that nothing was gonna happen right then and there. So, at that point. So this is what I've been planning to do for the longest. And you can wash it and everything. Once you do it, you can wash them, everything. I mean, you can go swimming. It won't come out, but just wash your hair. Don't go swimming and not use some shampoo. Or at least wash it with conditioner. You need to rinse your hair off. Rinse it with water if you're allergic to that. But you need to do something. Don't just get out of that chlorine water. I know it's the winter, but people have indoor hot pools, whatever. Don't just get out the water. And don't... because then you can mess your hair up. So I just filled the beater up real quick, as quick as I could. So you gotta watch it, because some of them might slide back off, and you don't want your work to go to waste. You can always just put a little rubber band on the end until you finish beating them. Because what'll happen is, so you stick the beater through the hair through the hole, and you just slide the beads up. Less time consuming. But what you need to do now is probably get a rubber band because that's how a lot of them messed up. So you don't have to count them at this point. You can if you want. I mean, shoot, you count a lot of beads. I didn't even count them. So I'm going for extremely long looking hair, but not too long. It's like kind of medium length. So I'm going to keep adding the beads. I got a little stopper right there. I'm not gonna do it all tonight. I'm probably just gonna do the 4 braids tonight, because got some things I need to do. I gotta do some work, get some work done. So I'll just work on it. Hopefully I can finish the rest tomorrow, because I'm gonna do the cornrows tomorrow, and I'll just bring up a video too tomorrow, because I gotta get my dough, you know? Good to get my dough. And you guys, please comment, subscribe. Hope this can help somebody. I know I don't have all the cameras and all that stuff to do the zoom ins and stuff, so you have to see better. I'm working on that stuff, okay? So I'm working on it. I plan to have that stuff by now, the camera that can zoom in and all that stuff, but yeah, everything is nice though. The way you plan for it too. I plan to have my equipment right now. I just don't get it just yet. Y'all bear with me. If anybody wants to get me that stuff, let me know. I'll put my P.O. box so people can send me stuff. Oh yeah, and I just had a sign. I did put my maternity bag on there. Everything went fine. Y'all seen when I put the maternity, what to take to the hospital bag up. He came out 8 pounds. Everything went well with him. So, yep, I did just have my son like 3 weeks ago. Okay, so then you just take the rubber band off. You're not going to put this rubber band on tight. You just want it on good enough to stop the beads from coming off. Because you're trying to get done. You know, if you put it on there too tight, you're going to have to go through a lot of unraveling. This just cuts everything and all the time down. Now, I know a lot of people now, nowadays, they like the longer hair, so I said, I'm going to just do them long so y'all can see how they look long with the beads. Show y'all how I would do it. Everybody has their own way. So, you might not want to have the beads all the way up covering your whole hair if you don't want to. If you can't braid that well, you can cover the whole braid with beads. You don't even have to show your braid. All they can see, well, if you can't braid the individual part that good, all they can see is beads, you know, and that's cute. You know, there's nothing wrong with that. But you can let a little slack off if you want and have the beads start down further like that if you want, which is the way most people do it. They have it where the beads start a little lower, or you can, oh, be careful, don't get your neck caught in there like I did. That was really weird. That's never happened to me before. Maybe because I don't normally put this many beads in my hair. I wouldn't put that much slack. I probably would want like just a little, like you can see the braid a little bit, and then I would fill the beads up to, that's probably long enough. What y'all think? Or just go on and go down to where I wanted it, because I wanted it right here, but that's like, that's almost like the same. So, yeah, I don't want the beads that far down. I want the beads to be up there. So, I'm just going to beat it one more time. Like I said, this is going to be a little more time consuming. So, I'm just going to wrap it around 3 times through a band and let it go. I'm not doing it tight. When you're ready to end it, you're going to put it on that tight one. So I just folded it here in half and wrapped the rubber band around that last bead, the one bead. You can do a pattern if you want. Like I said, I like doing patterns like two color. But like, because I'm doing these videos and I've been moving a little slower lately, especially since I had a baby and stuff and I'm still recovering. I'm just trying to get it done as fast as possible because I know I'm already moving a little slow. And it took me like 20 minutes to do one, so that's why I'm not gonna do them all night. I'll probably just do like the 4 in the back in front of y'all, and that's it. I'll probably do the rest tomorrow and put the video up tomorrow, the rest. But this is, you guys get the idea. And even when you do the cornrows, it's gonna be the same thing, but I'm gonna put the video up of how to extend the cornrows. You can do the same thing. You don't have to put the weave up here. You can just end weave at the end. Then it looks more real. It looks like it's your hair. You don't know where the weave was added. And I've been doing this for years, so I know what I'm doing. First you don't succeed, try again. I know I make it look easy, but no one's perfect. I've been doing this about 15 years, different things. So just practice makes perfect. You'll get it, you know. And if you need me to help you, or you need to ask me any questions, feel free to ask me questions. Don't just, you know, I've been doing it a long time, and I'm really good at following directions. Doing hair, you gotta listen to what, you know, the directions that's given to you. Even if you watch some of these videos on YouTube, you think you know everything. It's like, okay, I know how to do this, I see how they doing it, but I can't get it right, but I know how to do it, and I'm not gonna do it how they say it. Do it, try to do what they're telling you to do, and it might work. Don't just be like, oh, so close-minded, I already know and stuff. Give it a chance. Okay, that's the end of the braid. I'll make sure that it's braided right there. So I'm just gonna braid some more, just to be on the safe side. Cause I have to make sure the braiding side is tight. And okay, there we go. So there's a little slack in there. I was wondering. Okay, so this is a little past the R. There's a little slack in it. So I just wanted a little. I didn't want too much. I didn't want the part where I started to weave the show at all. I mean, you couldn't tell, but because like I said, I didn't put that much weave in there. I just put enough to just be able to put the bead on it and extend it. I don't, you know. So now you're just going to fold the hair over. You don't have to cut this yet. Just fold the hair over. So you will need some scissors. Fold the hair over. Take your rubber band. And rubber band it tight. Now you want to do it tight. You want to keep going over and over. 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 If you want to count the beads and do exactly the same amount of beads in each one, that's on you. This is a lot of beads to be counting. I would just try to make it look as close as possible. I mean, you can if you're that, you know, precise. There's nothing wrong with that. I mean, it's my hair, so it's like, you know, I'm just trying to show y'all. When I do lesser beads than this, I normally would count it, but this is a lot to be trying to count. Not saying I can't count now, y'all. So then you just cut that little piece that was hanging out, and then what you do is you take your beads and you push it down so it's covering the part that you rubber band and you can't see nothing. So now you got your extension. So I'm gonna do them all like that, but not right now. Nah. I don't got the time. So keep your trash can nearby. Unlike me, because if not, you're going to have trash around. So you guys can see. I hope y'all can see that. Like I said, I'm working on that. I had an iPhone. Yeah, it didn't work out too well, so. Got stolen from me. I fell asleep. I was homeless at one point. I fell asleep, and I had the iPhone, and I woke up, and someone had stole it from me. Right in front of me, like I literally woke up while they were stealing it, but I wasn't paying attention, and he ran off and jumped on the train. I was trying to charge my phone, and it was an iPhone, so probably sold it. I don't know. I don't even recall reporting anything stolen, so that was the stupid part. So somebody probably has an iPhone on me. And that's because I didn't report it. And they could have found it and gave my phone back because I still have to pay for that. Okay, so yeah, that's really cute. I like that. So we're going to do another one. What I did was I washed it and conditioned my hair with the braids in it. So, because remember I told you this was a pattern, a base pattern to what I wanted to do. It wasn't, I wanted this style, but I wanted it more extreme. I wanted it longer. This was the base to what I wanted. I just been waiting to extend it because I didn't have no time. I just had a baby, like, you know, you guys give me some slack. Come on, give me some love. Just give me some, cut me some slack. And because I do miss y'all and stuff. But I'll still be putting videos up. But I know I'll put as many up. Well, I'm going to do four now. I'm going to do the back four braids. So I'm showing y'all now how to do the individual braid. Then I'm going to show y'all the cornrow, which is pretty much the same thing. Except for this is down flat to the head. And then I'm going to still extend it on the end of the hair the same way. I sent it this one. So most people that braid, even if they didn't know my way, they if they can braid, they probably understand my method by now. It would be the people who don't know how to braid who may not understand the whole thing at all. So if you're not a braid, you probably understand what I'm saying. And this is another method you can use, you know. And everybody's got these new styles coming out. So I said, let's just do the old-fashioned, you know, old-fashioned regular beads. I was going to get all clear like I told y'all, but I figured these would be more more lively, more vivacious. And I like the colors. I love rainbows and stuff like that. So I also got some other beads too we're going to do something else with later. So y'all be looking forward to this. I might have to go back and get another pack of these. I don't know if this is going to be enough for this for a style, but I got these two. I could have put one of these at the end of each one of these two, but I don't know. I just was like trying to come up with something because I told you guys, and I know some people might have been waiting on me to do it and been like, well, what happened? She just played us. It wasn't that. I just didn't do it. I just didn't have the time. So I'm gonna take down the next braid because you know, like I said, it flooded and stuff, and I was tired, and I had been trying to work my other job, and because, you know, my baby need pampers and milk and stuff while I'm off of my other job, just to see if I can make some extra money on the side. Just some petty cash. I mean, it wouldn't be enough to really. It just would be enough for like milk and diapers. I'll be back at my regular job real soon. So that's it. You just take that out and comb that out. Get you some more of that watermelon edge fixer. Oh yeah, you can put some on as you braid. You can put once you put the weave in. You can add more of the watermelon fixer to blend it more. But this is the exact color of my hair because you guys know I dye my hair jet black. So this is the exact color of my hair. So if I was to like just want it to look like my hair and not put the beads on, I could do that too. And I'll show y'all how to do that too. But right now I just wanted to put beads. I don't know why I wanted to wear beads. I just wanted to put some beads on my hair one day. It was really weird. I just was like, I think I want beads, and then just did it. This is some good hair. This is a real popular hair. It doesn't really tangle that much. It tangled because the way I have it sitting there and the way I was playing with it, but not really. It really is some really good hair. It's really pretty popular. It's the kind a lot of people use. Expressions, yeah, that's the kind that a lot of people have been using. So I use all different kinds, but this one I know is pretty popular. So I took my little piece out. You don't want it to be too thick because you need the braid to be able to like I said, you need the braid to be able to fit through the bead. You don't need it thick. Start your braid, pull it tight, braid it down halfway, and then you're going to add the weave in. You're just starting a regular three-strand braid. There's no cornrow right now. This is just a regular no-knot. We're doing a regular no-knot braid. So then, find where you're at. You're gonna place the weave under your hair, and then you're gonna continue to braid it. Pull it tight when you're hiding it, tucking it under. Once you braid it down a little bit, like I said, that's when you're gonna start to pull the little piece from one side, one piece of braid, little piece of weave. You're not really trying to get your hair, you're just trying to get a piece of that weave. And add it to the middle piece of hair. You're not really trying to get your hair, just the weave. Just so that you'll have three long pieces of hair. You're going to do it again. Get a little piece of the biggest piece and add it to the other one. And then it should be three equal sections of weave. And then pull it tight though as you braid it. Braid it on down. Keep pulling your hands through as you braid to prevent the hair from tangling. Every three or four wefts, you want to pull your hands through like that. That'll stop it from tangling. Then once you get the hang of it, you can speed up some. Because if you move slow, it's going to take forever, you guys. I'm just going to do the four for now. Because, like I said, I don't even know how many of the cornrows I'm going to do. I may do most of those and then do the end of those on here. I don't know. I think it's better though when I tape it, because then if I tape it, normally I take lesser time when I tape it. I don't know why, but I guess it's less breaks and all that. Yeah. And I always have you some water. You feel thirsty? Stop what you're doing. Get you some water. Your health is more important. If you're not healthy, you ain't gonna be able to do your hair anyways. And it's your hair, so you can, if you make a mistake, bad. Pretty thirsty. She thirsty. She deeped up that drink. Just gonna do the four, because I'm not pressed for time, but I'm making fit one cornrow in. I'm trying to see, and hopefully I have time to show y'all one cornrow. And that'll be, then I can give y'all put a picture of the finished product or something. Because see, I used to have all the video editing things on my iPhone. I had to download all that stuff, and it takes time, and right now, time just be moving fast for me, so I don't be having time to do all that video editing and adding titles and taking things out. My stuff is just raw and uncensored. It's not even it's none of that. No special effects, nothing. It's the truth. It's real talk, this is like rough. This is like the rough draft. You get the real deal is a rough draft. Because normally, knowing me, I be trying to put my makeup on and everything, my lashes, be all perfect. Like, I'm just all, most people are just trying to make it seem like everything's all perfect, but it's not. That's how I was in my my old channel. But, like I said, without an iPhone, this is, and, with no time on your hands, this is how things go. So, you can speed up. Once you once you get in the hang of it, speed up. But make sure when you're speeding up, you pay attention and make sure that the braid does at least, you want it to look neat. I mean, it's possible. No one's perfect, but it doesn't have to be perfect, because like I said, this is not gonna be this is not gonna be showing. This part will not show. And the way that you know that you braid it down enough, you want to compare it to the other one. That's why you may not want to go down as long as I did. If you just want to do it just to make it look like you got longer hair. I mean, to right here would be actually really cute. I'm just being over the top. I don't have to be this over the top. Because I could have did more braids if I wasn't being over the top. I know better. Over the top, give you some over the top time that you gotta do it. It takes longer. So, yeah. Okay, so keep comparing. And you wanna braid, remember, you wanna braid a little longer than the part that you're beading, because the braid has to go around the bead and you want it to be tight. You don't want it to be. And be careful not to put too much hair in the braid, because you don't want the bit. If your beads get stuck, you all this work you just did, you gotta take that braid down and you gotta redo it. But the good thing about if you make a mistake, you don't have to take it all the way down. You can just cut, since you have so much hair, you got plenty of hair. You can just cut it to how short your hair is and then take the braid down. You don't have to take this whole braid down unless you're stretching hair. I mean, with that much hair, that is enough. If you were doing other people's hair, that is enough hair to do, like, the way I'm adding the weave in. I'm showing y'all ghetto ways to do this, okay? Ghetto ways to get the same result. The way I'm adding this weave in, I'm not adding it up here or nothing. Man, you'd have enough for, like, a whole family's head. You do that, like, five people's head. In a similar style, you know. You can do a mohawk. You can do all kinds of stuff similar. You can just, you don't have to add the weave up here. I mean, then it looks real, you know. I mean, only reason people would know it's not real. Okay, you don't got to talk like I did and go way past where you need to go. But it's okay. You don't have to take it back down. Just start beading. Because once you cut it, it's cool. You just wanted to get it far enough down. So let's just pray we didn't make that braid too thick. Because that's what I was looking at. I was hoping that it wasn't too thick. Nope. Yay! And then you just want to get a rubber band. And then take the last bead you got and just do the 1, 2, 3. So the hair is folded and you just loosely got it on there. Because you don't, because what happened to me the first time, y'all seen it, all of the hair, all the bead fell off the hair. So I said I got this big pack of beads, hey, why don't I just go and use them? And there's plenty of them, so I know I have enough. I know this is, I mean, this is still pretty full. This is pretty full. I should have enough to do my whole head. If not, I just go get some, but I should. It's enough for, because I said I might as well use them instead of just putting like 5 or 6 on there and going to use them. And that could be possibly enough for 2 people, but not 2 people getting up having the beads as long as I got them. I mean, it'd be enough for a whole, like, 4 or 5 kids if you're just putting 6 or 7 beads on each braid. You know, mama trying to survive. You want to make the kids go to the salon, you know, hey. Just trying to make it, and I totally understand that. So be the next thing. Hey, what's up? What you doing, little boy? So I just gave him a bottle, and then he farted and woke up. That was funny. That was really funny. But it's not gonna be funny when I have to, if it's something else he's doing, and I have to clean it up. It ain't gonna be funny then. Oh, he's going back to sleep now. So I shouldn't have to do it more than like 3 times, I think, was the amount of times I did it the first, 3 or 4 times the first time. So let's hurry up and try to do it before he wakes all the way up, because he's over there doing something. I think it'll be enough for my whole head though. It's definitely enough for one person to do what I'm doing. I don't think I did that many braids. I mean, maybe it's not though. We'll see. I'll just go get some more beads. I mean, they were $2.99 for one pack. I mean, that's why I put more on there. I tried something with more of them because it was taking me, it was so many beads left, and I was like, well, I want to use them, you know. How can I use them? And then I said, you know what? Maybe I should do them a lot farther down. He may not be gonna have it. I'm gonna have to pause this again. He may not gonna have it. He may be saying, no, mommy, you gonna have to check me out now. I just gave him a bath and stuff. sometimes if they're going back, he likes to bathe you. You're gonna have to bathe him all over again. Justin. He ain't crying, he's just kind of agitated. He wants me to pick him up right now. Okay, mommy, just put these one bead on here and then I'm gonna get you. Check you out and see what's going on, because I'm smelling something. I don't know if that's gas or not. And I heard you fart, so maybe that's more than what I'm bargaining for. Oh, shoot. Yeah, it don't sound like you're done either. Oh, Lord. I plan on doing four. I may only end up doing two. Because time is not, and I gotta go work. Yeah, I know. Go on and finish, because I know you're about to do it on me. Okay, baby. Go on and finish. Oh my God. Oh Lord, have mercy. Go on and finish up, honey. He got a little changing table I take over there. Yes, let it go. Yes, mommy got you. Go on and let it go. Yes. It's okay. Oh. Let me put this stuff up, because he's about to throw a fit. I thought he was going to stay asleep for a little while. Nope. It's time. Okay, honey, bunny, honey. He's about to come out. You boo-boo? You just want to be seen, little boy. Mommy love you. When you're a mother, you gotta multitask. You gotta do like three things at one time. Golly. Yeah, I may only end up showing y'all two. But we'll see how long it takes me to change him, because I think I'm gonna have to change him and smell it something. And I may have to wash him too, because that might go through his clothes. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, he's going to the bathroom. Okay. And he likes to eat while he's using the bathroom. So now he's like mad at me. He's like, you can't breastfeed me or give me a bottle. I just gave you a bottle, but okay, I'm gonna give you one. Give me 2 seconds. Put these beads on here. This is what moms do after multitask. Jeez. Y'all other mamas know what I'm talking about. So just match the ends up. If you put too many, just take a few off. You want to match it up good. So match it with the one you already did. You know, that's your guideline braid. So then you're going to try to see right here what's going on. Okay. So yeah. Doesn't have to be perfect, just similar. Hold up. just similar enough. Because if they're not perfect, it looks more real. Most people's hair ain't always even. But normally when it's this long, those people tend to keep their ends trimmed, so it is even. So just put your rubber band around the end. When you put it around the end now, you're going to wrap it around a whole bunch of times. Yes, mommy got her hands full. Okay. This ain't important. Okay, hold up. Okay, so I'm going to put all this stuff away. I'm going to have to deal with him. Okay, let me check. Sound like he's still going. Mommy love you. Yes, she does. I'm so sorry. Yeah, he's still going. He's like, I'm about to feed him some bottle or nurse him. Let's cut that little end off. Don't forget to do that. And y'all know to pull the braid down. The beads down over that end. You don't want that end sticking out. See how that's sticking out? You want to take and pull the braid up and put that, tuck that in and pull the braid over. If it's not tuckable, then that means you did it too long. So it should be tuckable. So it's tucked in. Okay, so that's two.
Love. You okay?
Okay, yeah. I'll be back. Let me pause this and check him because I don't know if he's done or not, but I'm just changing him in between. I think he's hungry. He wants some more food. So. Yeah. Okay, Justin. Okay, hopefully he's situated. And I gave him bottles, burped him, changed him. So, we're going to see. Maybe not because he's still awake, but he won't. I guess he's not sleepy, so. We're gonna see. He was a big, just like I said, a lot of going on. He finally let it go. So, yes, this many beads left, so maybe I'll just buy clear if I can't find this same color for the top row. But for now, we'll just do the four on the bottom. Doesn't seem like it would take that many, but maybe it does. Maybe. Because like I said, I wanted to use them. So, I was wondering how I could use more and not leave so many in the pack. So, yeah, I used a lot. So, I'm going to go probably tomorrow. I'll just do the four, and then tomorrow I'll go and get get some clear ones for the top row. And just do clear on the top, and just have these colorful ones on the bottom. That would be kind of cute. If I can't find no more colorful ones. If I find some more colorful ones, I'll just do more colorful. And I might need two packs of the clear because seems like that was only two braids and it took a lot of the pack. The ones I used before, I reused them. I put them back on the stick. So we'll see how many I can do. It looks like it's enough of how many I used so far. It's like 1, 9, 2, 3, 4. It's enough for like 5 braids. So we'll see. The way that it seems like that much is a braid. It's that many on one braid. It's quite a bit. So I'm just going to do the last two, and then that's probably going to be it for tonight. And I left my door open, I think. Sometimes it looks open, but it's not. Let me see. When I wash my hands. So, yeah, if I run out, I'm just going to have to get some more. I'm not going to be able to complete, I won't be able to complete this tonight because it looks like I would run out. I thought it would have been enough, though. It didn't seem like it was taking that many days. So, the ones I take off, I just put on there. And it uses about four sticks and a half for braid or beads. But like I said, I want to use them. I don't want to just keep having them inside of the container. I want it to go on and on. If I would have knew that, I would have went by there today. But I, like I said, I didn't even get a chance to even put none on there to see how many beads it would take. I thought that would have been enough, but I guess just looking at it, it's not. So the people that bead and are watching would know too. I'm not the only person that wears beads. So it looks like half of them are gone. So yeah, it might just get enough for two more. For the last two. I don't know. Just enough for a little more then. Because I thought it would at least be enough for like 10 braids. Like this, because there's so many, but I guess isn't once they spread out, it's not as many as it looks like. I guess this is half the pack right here, or almost half. So I wasn't gonna be able to do them all anyways right now. I remember I planned on just doing four and quit giving up on that for now anyway. So I'll put some of the edge control. That pack of beads just for me. I don't have a family to share those with. It's just for me. You know, I'm the only girl. My son, his hair's not long enough for that. Trying to save money. I call myself trying to save money. So I go back in the, hey. What's going on, little man? You wouldn't drink your third bottle. I mean, second bottle. She had two earlier. Okay. Trying to see, does he want a bottle or what? Because I just gave him a bottle and fed him. Because I fed him right before. Sorry, that looks a little bit too thick. I'm not sure. Hold on. Yeah. You don't want it too thick. Because then the beads won't go. You got my attention. So you just do the same thing you was doing. Take a little bit out of the other braid. Keep braiding down. Whichever one's the thinnest, you take a little bit out of the thickest one. Because you till you get each one even, then you just keep braiding it as tight as possible. You want to pull it tight. You don't want it loose. And run your hand through it every, I want to say 4 to 5 strokes. Like, you can see how I'm braiding like this. Then you want to just kind of pull your hand through. Because if you don't, what happens is you just keep braiding like this. You'll create another braid at the bottom and it'll tangle. It won't come out. You'll have to untangle it from the bottom, which should take up more time. When this is already time consuming as it is. What does that mean? What does that mean? Thank you. And you full already or something?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Maybe not.
Cool. Okay.
Mommy loves you.
Screaming like something's wrong with you.
This out the way. These last. This is only two. One more after this.
Just want to do the same thing, braid it down, and just match, braid it down as far as you braid it down, please. And as you go faster.